So, what you should not learn to be a malware analyst? I know this sounds a bit strange. What do you mean with something with what I should not learn to be a malware analyst? But here's the thing. Malware analysis is really, really a huge field. It's a huge, it's very daunting. And if you try to learn so many different things, especially at the beginning, it may take you 1, 2, or 3 years until you are in an interview ready level. But there are lots of things that you should not focus on at the beginning in your malware analyst career. In fact, you should not even learn them before you get a job in malware analysis. After I got my first job and the second and the third, there are so many things that I started to learn and things that I'm learning right now. Let's say reversing a malware written in Go language or things like that. Even how to analyze a Mac malware is something that I started with very recently. So you don't need to learn everything at the beginning. And here are some of the things that you really have to skip. And there's so many people are actually falling into that. Here are the things that you should skip learning, especially at the beginning. First, you should not go for CCNA for basics for malware analysis. You need network background, yes. You need to understand protocols, yes. But here are the most important protocols. Like you need to learn TCP, IP, UDP, HTTP, HTTPS, and some of these application protocols. But you don't need to learn all the routing protocols, even the ARP protocol, you don't need to learn about it. SSDB and all of these protocols, you don't really need to learn about them in malware analysis, especially at the beginning. And of course, you don't need to learn how to use Cisco. For me, until now, I don't even know how to use Cisco. I never used a real router before, like a real Cisco router before. I have touched base with the commands and dealing with their advisors, security advisors, but I never actually used the device, and I don't need that, especially in malware analysis. So there's the first thing. The second thing, you don't need to learn how to decompile a Python malware or dealing with Linux malware in x64 that's packed or things like that that you see so many times in CTFs. People join CTFs and they think that this will help them get the skills that they can use in malware analysis or in whatever the field they are trying to learn. But here's the truth, especially in malware analysis, it is a huge field. And you need to be very sharp, focused at the beginning if you want to learn malware analysis in the first 6 months or and be in an interview ready level in 6 months or 1 year. Then you need to skip so many different things that are actually not important at the beginning. So don't try to run after this interesting stuff. They are really interesting and there's lots of curiosity. I always have curiosity for them. However, they are not the fundamentals. You need to focus on the fundamentals. Third thing, you don't need to learn programming. So here's the thing. Programming is really a big field. It's about problem solving. It's about dissecting the problem into logical steps that the computer can understand. It's about designing an application, structuring the application, creating classes, objects, structures, functions that talk to each other. You need to code all of that, and then testing, deployment, all of these things, that's all programming. You don't need all of that. Definitely don't need all of that in malware analysis. You may need to learn the syntax of some languages, some basics about programming, because you will be reading code, and you will not be writing that much. You will be mostly reading code. And optional, kind of between mandatory and optional, at the end of your learning malware analysis process, you will need to learn how to use Python to automate some tasks in malware analysis. Let's say a malware that has, you know, 30 functions that need to be decrypted or 30 strings need to be decrypted, and you need to automate that in Python. That could be like 10 lines of code. However, you don't need programming as a whole. So trying to get a Java course or C++ course or something like that as an intro to malware analysis will be mostly a waste of time. However, you will need to learn the syntax. And as well, you don't need to understand how to deal with so many different programming languages, including, let's say, AutoEd, you will be touch base with PHP, with PowerShell, with Java, with C Sharp, with all of these languages. You will be in touch base with them. But the reverse engineering skills that you build while analyzing malware works on all of these languages. I never wrote a single line in Perl. Well, maybe I wrote a single line, but I didn't write in Perl. I didn't write in Autoit. I didn't write in so many different languages that I have actually, or even PHP, but I have actually analyzed different malware samples that are written in these languages. So you need to learn the reverse engineering skills and understand the general syntax. And that's all of it. If you are dealing with a new malware with a different language that you have never wrote a single line before in this language, including Java, you don't need to learn the language. You just have to use a bit of Google and what you have learned already from understanding the basic C++ syntaxes. So you don't need to go deeper in programming. And last, you don't need to learn how to deal with algorithms, for example, or lots of mathematics, or all of that encryption, like the encryption algorithms and all the things behind it, you don't really need. The same for electronics or things like that. You don't need that, except if you will be specialized in an IoT, for example, you will have to deal with hardware and electronics, or you want to be actually working cryptography, then you will need to learn cryptography and algorithms. But in malware analysis, the normal malware analysis, you don't need to deal with all of that. You definitely don't need to learn data structures, algorithms, mathematics. You don't need all of that in learning malware analysis. So that's how to skip so many things that actually could be wasting your time. If you want to know what actually you should learn and what actually the roadmap that you have to follow, what are the common wrong beliefs, same as I mentioned today, and what are the ways to deal with all the obstacles, I have created a masterclass long time ago. I have recorded it. And this masterclass, I actually explain all the steps that you have to follow to build your skills in malware analysis in a short time. There is no shortcut, but this is actually the fast way you can learn. I will put the link maybe somewhere here. So check it out and see you in the next video. Bye-bye.